Hi guys, Jordan with Motion Array, and today we're gonna take a look at how to use the mirror effect. Mirroring is one of those effects that if you don't know it's there, you can go your entire Premiere Pro career without using it. But you shouldn't, because it's a really cool effect. And the entire montage that you saw beforehand, every single shot used the mirror effect in some way, shape, or form. So let's jump right into Premiere Pro and take a look at how to use this effect.
The first thing we want to do is just bring our footage onto our timeline. We have a couple of example clips here to go through to show you the different variations of this effect that you can achieve. So to use the mirror effect, we first need to find it in our video effects folder. Either search for it through the folders under video effects, distort, mirror, or search for it on the search bar here by just typing in mirror. Here's where you have two different options to apply this effect. You can either drag it and drop it right onto your individual piece of footage, or you can place an adjustment layer on top of your footage and then apply the mirror to the adjustment layer instead. We're going to come back to the adjustment layer route later on, but for right now, let's just add it directly to our piece of footage. When we add it, we should see nothing really change, but if we go to our effects controls panel, we should see the new effect able to be used. There's only two parameters that you can work with, and they're reflection center and reflection angle. Basically, they both work together to tell Premiere where to draw the mirror line within your shot. By default, at 0 degrees and the default center, your reflection should be just off the screen to the right. But if we move the x-axis over to the left, we can start to see the effect come into frame. And right off the bat, you can see how easy it is to make everything symmetrical. But you don't have to have it directly in the center. You can if you want, but the reflection will show the mirror of whatever it's up against, no matter where it is in your frame. You'll also notice that when the angle is completely vertical, moving the center in the y-axis, up and down, won't really do anything. It's because you're technically holding up an infinite mirror, and raising the mirror up doesn't really change what you see. You'll only notice it once you start to shift the angle here. Let's try some more variations. Let's rotate it 90 degrees and see what happens. Now our mirror angle has shifted so that it's reflecting everything above it. So now our shot of the city looks like a perfectly still glassy ocean reflecting the clouds. Pretty cool, right? And like before, we can move around where this image starts to be reflected. And at 90 degrees, our left and right movement doesn't do anything. Rotating it another 90 degrees to get 180 degrees will be a complete inverse of what we first looked at, mirroring the opposite side. And finally, another 90 degrees to 270 degrees will get us the effect that you saw originally in the montage. You may have seen tutorials on other ways to get this sort of inception city on top of a city effect. And there's a lot more intricate, complex ways that you can go about getting this particular effect. But for a purely stylized version, this is a pretty easy way to go about it. And keep in mind that all of the other non-90 degree angles are capable of being used too. The more you play around with it, the more you'll see new ways that you can actually use this effect. And you can even stack them on top of each other to get a multiple kaleidoscope effect. Like the one that you saw in this shot here. Keep in mind though, once you start to layer more than one or two mirror effects on top of each other, the effect will start to bog down your computer a little bit, depending on how powerful your setup is. Every time you stack a new mirror effect, it will take into account each previous mirror effect. And if you take it too far, the effect won't have enough to draw from the other side. So it'll show the black edge of the frame like it is right here. Keep this in mind as it's an easy way to start making your effect look pretty bad. You can see that if we give a noticeable edge to the frame and we try to add another mirror effect to the frame, it doesn't go past the edge, even though technically it has area from the reflected edge to take from. But you can get around this by utilizing an adjustment layer, like we mentioned at the beginning. Let's bring the adjustment layer over top of this piece of footage and add the mirror effect on top of it. Now, when we move the mirror effect around in the adjustment layer, we can see that it starts to cover up this black space here, and now everything that was a part of the previous clip gets reflected. This is another advantage to using adjustment layers to mirror your clips. Anything below that adjustment layer will get reflected. So if we raise the adjustment layer a few tracks, then add some more footage underneath it, and blend it all together so that all the layers can be seen through each other, Then we see that our final result is a reflection of everything that's below the adjustment layer. Play around with this effect and see all of the awesome things that you can come up with. Make one simple reflection angle, or put together a bunch to get a trippy kaleidoscope effect. I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, give it a like, or a lot of likes. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, and feel free to even share this with a fellow video editor friend. Also, if you're interested, we've linked to a couple preset packs that give a mirror effect that takes it to a little bit more of an elaborate and stylized look. And if any of these pieces of footage from the opening montage caught your eye, well, guess what? They're all stock footage from our library here at motionarray.com. We've linked to each of them in the description below. If you pick any of them up, make sure to use this discount code in the description to get 20% off your first month's subscription. Thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.